Welcome to part two, where we're going to find the answers for the questions that accompany 12.3 of your AQA textbook. Let's have a little look. Ultrafiltration is caused by high pressure. It's the high pressure created here that forces those substances out. Number two, ultrafiltration causes filtration of the blood on the basis of size. It's size that decides whether that pressure can force those substances through those gaps. Name the substances that are found in the filtrate. Well, we're going to have water, we're going to have glucose, we're going to have urea, and we're going to have salts. How are glucose and mineral ions selectively reabsorbed? By active transport. Why is urea absorbed? Well, it's an unfortunate consequence of the system. Urea is only absorbed because it's got a concentration gradient and it's just absorbed by diffusion. We don't spend any energy reabsorbing urea. Why are mineral ions reabsorbed? Well, by reabsorbing the mineral ions, we control our water balance. If we want to reabsorb more water, if we haven't drank a lot that day, or it's a hot day and we're sweating a lot, then we're going to reabsorb more mineral ions to reabsorb more water by osmosis. And why would there be a large number of mitochondria here in the selective reabsorption area? Because that's where ATP is produced, and ATP fuels active transport, which is what is reabsorbing the substances back into the blood. Now, just as a final point, lots of the questions when they ask you about this, what they're looking at a lot of the time is what is the difference in the composition of blood here compared to there? Or they might be asking you about the difference between the composition of the filtrate and the blood. Or they might be asking you about the amount, the relative reabsorption of these products on a hot day, a dry day, on a day where you do lots of exercise, and so on. That is where most of the questions are angled.